Good afternoon, doctors. Welcome again. Today our topic is renal cell carcinomas. So we see secondaries in renal cell carcinoma most commonly is lung, and in lung what we see cannonball mets, or we see cannonball mets in case of seminoma of testes also, remember. So these are the cannonballs location, cannonball mets. This one cannonball, this one is cannonball, this one is cannonball, here x-ray, this one cannonball. So these are the appearance of chest x-ray in renal cell carcinoma secondaries. Now renal cell cancer, we are going to revise this topic. Okay, renal cell cancer, we can say renal cell cancer, or we can say hypernephroma, or Gravitt's tumor, or clear cell adenocarcinoma. Most common malignant neoplasm is 95%. Site of origin most common is PCT, is proximal convoluted tubule. It is mainly situated on upper pole, and male is to female ratio is 2:1. Common presentation triad here is, I will show you. The triad for renal cell carcinoma is 3, hematuria, flank pain, and palpable flank mass. But in case of earliest, most common presenting features is hematuria. Most common feature is hematuria. But in case of Wilms tumor in a babies, it causes hematuria, fever, and mass. Why fever? No pain, because a little baby can't able to speak that he is suffering from pain. That's why fever. Okay. Triad. These are the renal cell carcinoma showing in this picture. These are the normal kidney disease. But this one is renal cell cancer. Okay, remember it. Now, we are going to discuss some paraneoplastic syndromes. Okay, let's start. In case of liver, we see paraneoplastic syndrome, that is erythrocytosis, hypercalcemia, and hypoglycemia. But in case of renal cell carcinoma paraneoplastic syndrome, that is anemia, polycythemia due to increase in erythropoietin and increase ESR here. So we are going to discuss more. Stouffer syndrome, what is it? It's non-metabolic elevation of liver enzyme. The treatment is radical nephrectomy. Okay, removal of adrenal gland, kidney, and ureter, all three. In case of bilateral renal cell carcinoma, if the size is less than 4 cm, then subtotal or partial nephrectomy. If size is more than 4 cm, then total radical nephrectomy. Okay guys, now most common route of metastasis, that is hematogenous. Most common site of distant metastasis is lung. We see already cannonball appearance. And the secondaries is cannonball. Okay, investigation of choice is computed tomography scan, or we can say CECT. Treatment is radical nephrectomy. Radio and chemo are little role, or we can say no role. Okay. Now, chemotherapeutic drug, first line, that is sunitinib and vinblastine, single agent chemo, most effective. Now we are going to discuss about Wilms tumor. Chromosomal anomaly on 8th and 11th chromosome. Most common earlier symptom is flank pain or abdominal lump. We can say abdominal lump Wilms, because it is not pain, it is in child. Most common site of distant metastasis is also lung here. Abdominal pain, fever, hematuria, anorexia, hypertension, nausea, and treatment is surgery, chemo, and radio, all three tried. Now Wilms tumor, stage 1 kidney, left kidney is normal, right kidney stage 1, treatment is right radical nephrectomy. Vagar syndrome, W4 Wilms, A4 aniridia, and G4 genital anomalies, and R4 mental retardation. Then there is a two classifications here, like NWTSG, that is National Wilms Tumor Group of surgery. So it indicates do first surgery group. Then SIOP, it's International Society of Pediatric Oncology, so oncologists prefer chemotherapy, remember this. Okay, now we are going to discuss more. Bilateral Wilms tumor, chemo is indicated. Now we are going to discuss angiomyolipoma. It's a benign tumor of kidney, hematoma or fat in a lesion, 50% associated with tuberous sclerosis. So let's separate the word. In angio means vessels, myo means muscles, and lipoma means fat. So when there the vessels, rupture of vessels occur, it due to hemorrhage, it's known as Wunderlich syndrome. It is known as Wunderlich syndrome, and investigation of choice is CT. Clinical feature, hematuria, flank pain, palpable mass, hypovolemic shock, hypertension, and anemia due to rupture of vessels. Spontaneous hemorrhage, retroperitoneal, it's Wunderlich syndrome, remember guys. Treatment, if the lesion is less than 4 cm, observation and follow-up annually means once a year. And if the lesion is more than 4 cm, then mild symptoms, then biannual means 2 times in a year. Investigations, okay. Now, if the lesion is more than 4 cm, moderate severe symptom pain, hemorrhage, selective embolization, and partially nephrectomy is indicated here. Earliest feature of tuberculosis on IVP, that is blunting of calyx. Remember, guys, kidney of tuberculosis, most common presentation is increased frequency. 3-day early morning specimen for AFB, sterile pyuria, and WBCs increases here. Okay, guys. I already cleaned this till here. Okay. Now, IVP, we see blunting calyx, CT scan, we see cement or putty kidney. Golf hole is seen in ureter tuberculosis. Most common site of genitourinary tuberculosis is kidney. Timbal bladder seen in tuberculosis, urinary bladder, and renal trauma, there is hematuria. IVP, right kidney is not visualized, right renal artery injured, repair the artery then in case. See. Blunted calyx on IVP. This is blunted calyx is seen in tuberculosis. Now this is the shape of kidney. We see here cement and putty kidney on CT scan. And see, this is a timbal bladder here, tuberculosis of urinary bladder. So guys, have a good day, goodbye, and that's all for today. If you have any queries, any question, then you can ask me. And if you still not subscribe my channel, please subscribe it. Good day. And